Hey buddy, and welcome to another FAQ episode, and this time we're gonna discuss story mode. Now story mode falls under the extra tab. It's a mode where you play through different tables. You go through the whole history of the manufacturer, starting at the EM tables, and then moving on a little bit further every time until you get to the solid state, and then you go through the more modern tables, and then you're ending at Stars Phoenix, which is the last solid state table. So you start at the beginning and you end much later at the end of the production stage where the last machine was produced, and you get then different tasks. Each table has a different task. You complete that and you move to the next table, and there are 41 tables in total. Now story mode is accessible on most of our platforms, and it's played in an arcade setting, which means the flippers are longer, the playfield is slower, so slightly slower than simulation, and you can also nudge unlimited, so there's no tilt in here. First, about the scoring on story mode. There's a separate leaderboard for it, and there's different factors that have an influence on your score. Now, a normal player or a new player who starts in the game will have 10 balls and will get 99 seconds per table. Now, those 99 seconds won't change, but the 10 balls will, because if that person plays more of the game, we'll get more achievements or quests. And for each 100 achievements or quests, you get one ball. You get 500 quests, you get 5 extra balls. So you start with 15 rather than the standard 10. So the total starting balls depends on how much you have unlocked in the quest or achievement section. But it's not the only matter that matters. There's other factors that have an influence, like the amount of tables that you've completed. If you complete one table, you get 125 points. So the further you get, the more points you get as well. The more tables you complete, the more points you get, the higher you go into that ranking on the scoreboard. What also matters is that if you manage to complete the story mode, you also get 125 points per ball. So if you complete 2 balls, you get 250 points. But that's only the case if you actually complete the story mode. Another factor that will have an influence on your score is a time remaining per table. And you get 1 second per point. So if you have 10 seconds left, you will get 10 points. You got 50 seconds left, you get 50 points. And that's quite important. So you always have to play with quite a bit of speed, because the sooner you complete the table, the more points you get. And, you know, over 41 tables, it will make a difference in the long run. So you quickly start to see a separation between the advanced players and the beginners. And also you see the big difference between people who have never played it and people who know exactly what to do. That's also a big difference. Played for the first time, or have you played it a couple times more when you know what to do? And then there's the situation where 99 seconds weren't enough and you still need more time. What then happens is that your scores start to count down. Again, 1 second per point. So you will be a little bit punished when you don't complete that table in that 99 seconds. So those are the factors that matter for the scoring. These factors have an influence on your scoring. So these were the basics of story mode. I might still make a video where I go through all the levels, but for now this is it, and we're gonna see you next time in the FAQ.